This is Donald Trump.
If you could do it, why not?
Yeah.
So I'll go ahead and see if this one works out, since now I got it on record. Aho, mitake api, mi malakota. Hello, they're all my relatives. My full name, my English name is Peter Redhart. My Lakota name is Feather Gray Eagle. I'm originally from Crow Creek, South Dakota. As now as today, I live in Albuquerque, New Mexico. Our traditional greetings that I just said was hello to all my relatives. I am the Day Oyate Lakota from the Crow Pool of Missouri, which is Crow Creek, surrounded by South Dakota. I'm going to tell a little bit who I am and where I come from in our Lakota ways. And mainly, I will talk about the teepees today. Everything of the teepee that you see here, I want everyone that I always teach for more than 15 years that a teepee is a woman. It is everything of a woman, of the woman's and elements, points of what a woman represents and what it's meant for. So today I am 44 winters years old, and actually my mother, her name is Emma, and she is actually from the Crazy Horse Clan. My father, his name is Peter. I'm named after my dad, is Peter, that is actually served in the U.S. Army in Vietnam. He's actually from the Black Hills Clan. And my grandmother, mainly, is Dolores Feather Breen. So that name was given to me by my grandmother. And all through, I was born in 1972. And actually, I was born in a trailer. And we didn't have homes. We had all trailers and we were poverty land. And through a year later, in 1973, my grandmother, she was given that name as Feather Gray Eagle. And by the protesters and protesting in Wounded Knee in 1973. With all the relatives, as well as Russell Means and Dennis Banks, as well as other Mary Gray Eagle and so forth, and Strawberry. Afterwards, we moved down here to Albuquerque, though. For me, for schooling, and really, though, I actually went to elementary schools here, and I graduated all through elementary, middle school, and high school. I started playing the drum since I was 5, all through Archie Glenn. And all through high school, I graduated with a 3.9 grade point average. I was actually at the University of New Mexico for 4 years. I actually studied as a musician, as a music and recording artist, and also American Indian history, and so forth. Had two jobs for 31 years, actually. So, and single for 24 years, you know, so far. So, most likely for 44 winters years old, you know, I've really dedicated my life as a music, but mostly more spiritual life and history. It's always important to know who you are, where you come from. It's always important to know what's around you, to know your relatives, to what really goes to how we educate each other and how we know and help each other. So, as well as today, is if you are born here in the Western Hemisphere, you are a Native American. I am an American Indian. And I'm a Kota, Inate, American. And as much as our people, the Kota, the Dewa Yate, the Kotas, we have our other relatives, as well as the Abuelas and these Kishawans and so forth, and the Blackfoot, Cheyennes, Apahos, Shoshones and so forth, and we are actually called Teton Nation, all up in north, towards Canada, and all through the high Indies. So most likely, I have really dedicated myself in history, music, and all through spiritual life, and all through arts and crafts, as well as really studying what the teepee represents. It's always, teepee is a woman. It's always been a woman that has been here for tens and tens of thousands of years, even longer. So when you see these teepees, these are actually called the Northern Plains teepee. These are all created, actually, by Grandmother Earth. They all came from the earth. And as much as from tens and tens of thousands of years, many to where I always want all of my relatives and audiences to look at the teepees, to really know this really the construction, the spirit, built, and so forth. I'm going to play a little song for you, just a little one. And I'm going to talk about the history of tens of thousands of years, the moons, the many moons of the poles, the destruction, and the spiritual power of the teepee. Tens of thousands of years, how the poles met together, how Grandmother Earth put them together. We didn't have a high zone, because the highs are a living being, as well as the teepee today is a living being. Today, actually, from now to way back in tens and tens of thousands of years, through our ancestors, other ancestors, 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 all through ancestors, have used the teepee not just a home to live in. It was meant for ceremonies all through killings. It was a woman's covenant. It was a woman's teepee. Grandmother Earth designed this for her children, for Grandmother Earth's children, for the women. All for the women that she taught her women, her children, about healing, about ceremonies, how a woman takes care of her family, men, the people, so forth. The women are the only ones to how they know how to heal, how to teach, and especially how to have ceremonies to all the elements of the many, many moons and poles. We represent that everything that's around the teepee has been for tens and tens of thousands of years. Before the Haidas came, so Faisha Zen is, in the Lakota ways, we represent the 13 poles. Many tribes have many different poles. From 14, 13 poles through 18, many poles of what they represent. How many moons? What's around them? So many tribes have many different covenants. So Grandmother Earth made many different covenants, as well as the Idlu, the Kiva, the Navajos, the Tikis, the Cherokees, as well as the Sweat Lodges, as well as the Lodges, and so forth. So most likely, Grandmother Earth created everything from the earth to provide for her children, which is for the women to heal her men and the families. So, in the Lakota way, like I said, we represent the 13 poles. So I'm always starting off with the first pole. The first pole is next to the door, which is actually facing towards the east. It's always facing the door, always faces the east, that actually the sun that rises. So that's the fire sign to where the sun rises towards the door. So the first pole is the buffalo. It's the moon of the buffalo. It's the moon of the Tatanka. It is the Lakota of the Tatanka buffalo. It is the buffalo bull. The bull is that is used today for the hides, which is a living being for the teepee. So you put the hide around it to where it adds on for the warmth and for the teepee to stay in place, as well as the bull or the buffalo. It represents grandfather's sky's animal that's been here for tens and tens of thousands of years. The buffalo is how we survive from the buffalo. Gathers the medicines, gathers the grass, and eats all the nutrients. How we live from the buffalo. We use the buffalo from the bones, the hooves, the skull, the hides, the tongue, every bit. Is valuable to us, to how our bones are all buffalo bones, as well as we survive and follow the buffaloes. So that is the buffalo, the middle of the buffalo. That represents the next pole, and it's the moon of the grandfather. Grandfather's sky, grandfathers, and even all the grandfathers today. Grandfathers are the professors. These are our warriors. Grandfathers always teaching us and always knowing to what the instructions as well as what's around the outside of the teepees. Always bringing home the food, always bringing home the hide, the clothing, so these are grandfather's sky's children, which is grandfathers. These are actually the buffalo is one of the grandfather's sky's animals, just like the bear, which I'll talk later. So it represents the next moon, or the next moon of the hide, which is on the third moon pole, which is actually the turtle. The moon of the turtle. The moon of the turtle is Grandmother Earth's animal. It's the most beautiful, beautiful turtle animal that has a beautiful shell. Every woman has a shell. That's their protection. That's what they go to. That is a shell that represents the 12, 13 squares of the year. So you turn the shell over, that is the root of the tree. So every time when the turtle moves, it moves by love. It moves with love. Because it plants a tree, plants a tree, it's a tree, it's a tree, so forth. So turtle is the only one that plants trees, and that is grandmother Earth's animal that it represents the next pole. So turtle, as much as how it represents the squares of the year, the scales, how old it is, and as well as how it represents spirit, that mother Earth's sacred breathing of the tree, which is the next pole. And that is the moon of the tree. The moon of the tree is a living being like us, because we have the same DNA of the tree. So every pole of every tree is all connected into the poles of the moon. So we exhale the tree. So every tree to where we need more trees. So because we can't live without the trees. So it's important to know to how the tree we have the spiritual ways of knowing the trees, because how tall they are and how they connect to all the energy of the sun. The small ones are struggling because they can't get the energy from the from the sun because of the big trees. Excuse me. So most likely the trees are so important to where how we breathe breath better, to exhale with the tree. And it represents the next pole, which is the fifth moon. The fifth moon of the firefly. The firefly tells us and knows us that it brightens your lives, because there's a saying that firefly says to us, your life is brighter than ours. So fireflies are around because living beings like us, we have a brighter life to where we go out into the bright lights, into our heart, and as well as to our mind and spirit. So firefly always tells us those things, so which is a messenger. Okay? It represents the next pole. So the next pole, that represents the whales. The whales and the wolves, just like those are all grandmother Earth's animals. The whale is the heart of the ocean. It's the heart of grandmother Earth's ocean, all through the wolves that are the teachers, because the wolves are always around us. So those are is our spiritual guidances. It's important to know these sacred animals that are spiritual ways, that tells us, that shows us our spiritual life. So that is actually my fifth moon that represents the sixth moon. And so the sixth moon, that represents the eagle. The eagle is the mighty, mighty bird. The mighty of grandmother Earth's bird. The number one animal. That's related to the four animals, which is the buffalo, the wolves, the bear, and the eagle. The eagle always faces towards the west, into the door of the sun, because when the eagle shows the bravery is out there, it flies more higher, but it goes and talks, speaks loudly than the other birds, because it flies higher around the heavens. So this is where grandmother's spiritual bird that keeps an eye on us, how we're doing, how bravery, how our hearts are. So the mighty bird of the eagle is the number one bird, flies higher than any bird that there is on the earth. That represents the next pole. So, excuse me. Before I go on to the next pole, what I talked about was all of this half of the moons, which I talked about the east of towards the door. That is the east of the sun that rises. So much as the east, this is the south part of the pole, which is the desert area, turns into the southern area of the rainforest, of the southern south of the rainforest. Before I get to the north, and then it's the west part is to where the sun sets, of the Black Hills, of the Yansheng. So, as well, the sun sets to where the eagle stands. So, as well as the buffalo. So the next pole, which is actually the sixth pole of the moon, represents the bear people. The bear, the sign of the water. It is the water to what it is. The bear is, we call, Big Chief. It is grandfather animals there. Big Chief for the bear, for the bear people, it tells us to create your path. Create your heart to where your path and to be to where you're going to create where your paths are. Because Big Chief doesn't like trespassers. So most likely he's telling you to create your path wherever you go into the mountains, into the forests. Because that is Big Chief's land. So he's always providing you and telling you to really see the path. So the moon, the next pole, which is the eighth pole. The eighth moon, which is the spider. The spider of the moon and the pole. The spider always tells us to be responsible. To be responsible for your health, for yourselves, to what you're responsible to be really for your children, your wives, your mates, your families, to be really connected. She's always, always around with the insects. It's like we live with the insects. So the spider tells us to be responsible. So most likely don't be so irresponsible, because that's where there's many spiders. So the number one thing is the spiders showing and teaching us to be responsible. That represents the next pole, which is the ninth moon of the pole. And that one represents corn people. The corn of the people of the corn here in the south. The moon of the corn. These are corns here in the Pueblos that harvest the corn. One woman named Our Lady Guadalupe. The woman that is connected all corns, has gathered the corns. She's always knowing to really harvest and really showing everyone how sacred everything on what the corns, breads, how every food to what is nourished for our bodies and spirit. So that represents the corn here in the Pueblo area, which is towards the south. Okay. The tenth pole of the moon, which we talked about, from the corn all through the south to the west, that is the next one of the grandmothers. The grandmothers teaches us how to be reverent. To be reverent to yourselves. Wants us to really know your heart. It doesn't teach you your mind or how you think and all. Because grandmothers want you to follow your heart. That's why they're the professors. Every grandmother and women and all are the backbone of this earth. The grandmother is. That's why they're teaching you to be better. So much as them, those are the grandmothers who were as professors. That represents the next pole. And the next pole, that represents towards the heart. As the heart of yourselves, that is the most powerful element. That represents to have the heart spirit connected to your head spirit. To always want to use your heart. Always accomplish. Always follow your heart. Always create from your heart. Always use your heart. Don't use your mind. Because if you use your mind, you're going to go through a lot of stages, a lot of ways, and a lot of different eras to where you don't think well, and all you're going to create is karma. So karma is something you don't want to be around with. So always use your heart, but do steps with love. Always follow the heart of love. Do it with love. And always, that's what the Women's TP is teaching all of us. And the professors of backbone of women. Do it from your heart. Do it with love. That's why it's very, very important. So, out of all these elements that was all created through where as many moons to all three of the insects, the sacred animals, heart, as well as the grandfathers, the grandmothers, as well as so many moons that so many tribes have represented, so many have carried between 14 poles, 18 poles, or 7 poles, every element, where those were from tens of thousands of years. Okay? So before the hides came, which is the buffalo bull. The buffalo bull, of course, they put the hide around it. Now the buffalo bull, because that is what secures everything together. That's what keeps them warm. That's what protects them from our enemies. Because our enemies are the cold, high winds. We can't survive with cold, freezing cold, and high winds. So that's why it's important to when you put everything together, because everything stays in one. So these teepees are all together into the top of the lake, so it doesn't depend on the ground. Because the storms and high winds cannot knock those down. So not an earthquake or a tornado, or or any kind of storm. So I'm going to tell you about the destruction. The destruction of the teepees. And as I always look at the teepees, I always look at doors. How it's rounded. It's always round. Everything is round is sacred. Everything is round. The sun, the moon, the water drops, the rocks, the mountains, as well as the Black Hills, Bear's Teepee. Everything's round. The earth, grandmother earth, the whole earth that we live in is round. So everything is round to where it forms into a woman's circle. That is a woman's domain of a woman's covenant circle. That is her sacred circle that is provided around the poles. Okay. The poles are very much and the teepee itself and the hide itself is the most finest structural buildings that's ever designed and built from grandmother earth. It is best in the world. But it doesn't need a foundation. The teepee poles, they come together, the weights on top. Each one of them. It's always a weight on top. Because when you put the hide around it, it adds on to it. So it's all conical shape inside. How everything holds together. So when you look on the top, everything's conical shape. So it's, all comes together to where it doesn't depend on the ground. So because the weight's on top. So most likely to where you're inside the teepee, you're safe from high winds. You're safe from the cold. You're safe from all the enemies out there from the cold and the high winds. So it does not depend on the ground. That's why we put the high roof. So that is for the Buffalo Bulls. Before I get into the spiritual way, each pole to where each from the high is a living being today. So it's a living being of the teepee, just like our animals, our sacred animals and all of our insects. Those are all sacred. Those are all living beings, as well as us as humans. So the door, like I said, always faces the east when the sun rises, because the west is the sunsets. So most likely to always look at the four poles. And in the Lakota way of life, we always look at the four poles, or the four directions, the four points of the universe, the four seasons, the four elements, the four, they represent the so many meanings of the four points. And each pole is the four points, but inside, some of them are three. And those three is there's no west, because it faces towards the sunsets. Okay? In a spiritual way, in a very spiritual way, the poles that come together in unity, those are our warriors. Those are all of our brothers, all of our soldiers, all of the men, all the poles of the men that tie in unity as brothers. Okay? These are all of our men that's fought for our way of life, fought for the service, fought to protect the land, protecting our way of life, protecting us. They come in the unity. Those are all the men of all the poles that represent the men. The high he put around it, those are representing the women. Because the woman is the teepee that keeps us warm inside. Okay? But remember, women are the backbone. So you put the hide around them, this is how a woman takes care of you. Okay? She keeps you warm inside. She's keeping you humble. And as well as the flaps, you see here, the flaps that you open and close at night. Okay? Flaps, those are actually, the flaps, those are the woman's arms. See, close them at night. That's how a woman takes care of you. That's how she's keeping you humble. She's keeping you warm inside. Okay? The door has to be very small. Very small, because you have to bend down. The men have to bend down and crawl inside. We're crawling in because the woman's inside the teepee. So the women are teaching the men how to be humble and to understand that you're coming into a woman's covenant, to a woman's ceremony of healing, into a woman's domain. So it's teaching the men of understanding how to really know your true selves of heart and spirit. That's why the men come to the women for guidance, spiritual guidance, for tender love, for understanding. This is why the men will always go to the women, to always, if they are allowed to go into a woman's covenant, to a woman's teepee. That's why it's an understanding to know how spiritual and how sacred a teepee is. That's called the Northern Plains Teepee. That teepee is a woman. So before I get any questions about anybody first, I'll go ahead and continue through. And pretty much today, how everything is that there are over thousands and millions of teepees all over Grandma Earth. Everywhere you go and you see a teepee, you know that that teepee is a woman that's still standing, that's been there for tens and tens of thousands of years. Many tribes, many people have written symbols, really different art forms of the mountains, symbols of medicine wheels, different spiritual symbols, different any kinds of different elements that's put in, that those are all spiritual messages. And those are all different kinds of different symbols that's been here for tens of thousands of years, today and now, and in the future. So that's what we see today and later on in the future today. So we're always seeing the teepee of the woman. So most likely to every 500 tribes from all over the country that has a teepee. Everybody has a teepee. The word teepee is, it's always important to know when you're inside that it is a spiritual woman's covenant and very loving, and what the elements are around you to understand how it's changing. It's important to really know changes are every day of what our sacred animals, grandmothers, grandfathers, the directions, all into one. So that is the Northern Plains teepee of all of our different kinds of covenants that Grandmother Earth has built, that all came from the Earth. She designed all those, all for us. So if there's any questions or anything, any comments, any suggestions, any input, any feelings, any things, any, I can go on and on to where people or our relatives are feeling, but don't think of it. Feel the teepees. And how long when you were born that they were still there, what day you were born. They were still standing all through our ancestors, after ancestors, ancestors through. Yes.
So I'm actually going to comment to you that I never think of, look at, or know. Keep in the same way again in this moment now because we do this. And I appreciate the knowledge. And my tears started flowing when you talked about the beginning. Touched my heart deeply.
Yeah.
When you said that earlier.
I can fill in every single day. Everywhere I travel, all over Indian country, I've been into people's houses. I've talked to women. The stories they tell me. The first thing they talk about is what they've done. They don't regret it, but they do regret it. I asked them this, where do you come from? And tell me in your background, who are you and where you come from? Well, the first thing they talk about is their hair, their eyes. I have some native, I have Irish, I have white, I have England, I'm all like this thing. But, mainly them, it's nervousness. It's all these things what a woman is, to where it's common and normal to know where the men listen. And I want all the men to listen. because they're important to where a woman is crying inside. I'm feeling her to where I tell her this, where you come from? Where are you from? Everywhere, and I was at Standing Rock. Every woman and every lady was there. And they went up to me, talked to me, had microphones all over me. The first thing I say, where are you from? Where are you from? They keep talking. I say, where are you from? They're from Austin, Texas. They're from New York. If you're born here in the Western Hemisphere, you are a Native American. They can jump for joy. They can do, I mean, they've done that. They're screaming, all yelling and all, and I'm like, okay. Now they're knowing their true selves because we're all related into one. The four colors, which is I wear every day of my life. If you put the four colors together, black, the white, the red, and the yellow. You put the four of them together, get the color brown. It's the color of Grandmother Earth today. Is everything sacred? The blacks are for the blacks. White is the whites. The red is the Irish. The yellow is the Asians. What about the Spaniards? What about the Spanish people? What about us? You know, come on. You know, what about me? Put the whites and the Irish together, you get the Spanish people. The Spanish people are provided in groups. Latinos, Hispanics, Puerto Ricans, Italians, Cubans, and so forth. Okay? The blacks are different. You put the whites and you put the blacks and the Asians together. You got the Muslims, pro-blacks. You got the Arabs. You got the Albanians. You got so many other different groups, all of these basis colors, so forth. All through of natives, like the blacks, the whites, the Asians, the Irish, they're all natives. All different kinds of from South American natives, South America, North America. This is another story, a different story of the medicine world that is connected to two of our two Indian countries, between South America and North America, that has been here longer than tens and tens of thousands of years. That is the biggest history to where we live in the seven generations. The seven generations that is the only generation that we're living today. For your children, grandchildren, for your great-grandchildren, this is it. There is no other generation. So today is the 21st century. So very much to know, this is why the four directions and the four points are as the poles to each one of the teepees. So that's why 500 tribes, 307 reservations here in the United States. This is one big, huge Indian reservation. Everywhere you go, every city, major city, biggest cities, towns, is all Indian country. Everywhere. Yes?
Around 1980 or so, there was a big upset in the Dakotas between the Lakota tribes and the U.S. government, I guess. What was that all about?
In 1980, that's a different story that has to do with part of our President Roosevelt's in 1933, declaiming the Black Hills. This is why in 1973 we had a protest of our sovereign nations. That was the biggest history in that time to where in the 1900s, we didn't all exist. We didn't exist as Native Americans. How were we called as human beings? Who called us human beings? 1898, one man called us human beings. In 1898, the Pope himself, in 1988, called us human beings. 8 years after Mother Dee, by the woman in Nassau. Through the 1900s, all through, this is where today, at Standing Rock, we made history to knowing that in 1933, all through decade after decade after decade, that President Roosevelt, at the time, that fired Congress and fired himself, that the United States of America became bankrupt, became broke. All through the wars, all through Vietnam, all through our veterans, all through the riots in the 60s and 50s, through all through 1980, when the United States, and this is a different story because this is politics, this is a different side to what the United States wanted. How greedy it was to steal. They took everything from the Dakotas, the gold, the timbers, the uranians. We're still fighting the Black Hills today. In 1980, that's when the U.S. Congress reclaimed the Black Hills. $8 million to how much the Black Hills are worth. We don't have $8 million today here in the United States because we're all in poverty. We're all in bankrupt. That will never change. So today, chronicle this to where we are now as we're not a sovereign nation anymore. That is hard to believe. It's not a sovereign nation. As all the treaties that the United States has broken, all the treaties. This is a different side. This is a different, you know, this is politics between the United States into all of the treaties and different, all of these different laws that we are talking about world treaties, not just in the United States. All the world treaties. Okay. It is still, the battles are still going. While we're still defending the Black Hills, how we're protecting water, you know? Why we're in a war today, protecting water through, all through to where everyone is a Native American. We're not primitive. We're not as any other sovereignty or any kind of heathens that we were once called before Columbus came. It's a different story. These are all different stories of politics and all through. It's still going on today. It has been through the 1980s. It has been through the 90s, through the early 2000s, and today, and all through. You have to wait. You have to follow your heart. Pray every day. Every single day. Every one of us to pray for our relatives. Pray for our loved ones. We have to always follow our heart to listen to our loved ones. Always listen to your heart. You can't do it with anger. You can't do it with mental in your head. You have to listen to your levels. You have to listen to your heart. Do it for what's within you. A 50-year-old, a 60-year-old, a 70-year-old, an 80-year-old today that's still standing and fighting. That we can honor and cherish our veterans, our loved ones, our women. Today, that I've been last year, that I can't believe what Standing Rock is another story. Now you're knowing a human being, what we're made of, that we're still standing today, you know, that we're protected. it is always, it still continues in Dallas all through long. Is there any other questions?
I have a question.
Yes.
How big is the TV?
Just want to know how big this one is?
No, not this one. The regular TV.
Yeah, I had a question another person asked me. I recommend a 16-foot TP.
That's the
tallest. That's the tallest 16. The widest can go up to about 12 to where 10 to 12 foot round. I recommend the 16-footers because you can build fires. So you can
inside?
Hold. Yeah.
You actually have fire inside the TP?
Yeah. You can build a fire on the 16 foot. Don't put it on the 14 foot because you're going to burn the canvas. You're going to burn the high. Yeah. So always recommend the 16. That's how high. It can go up to 18 foot, 20 foot, 22 foot. As high as big it is to where it's normally for 16. So we can all build fires. So, yeah. So,
question. You mentioned karma.
Yes.
Is there a word in Native American language for that concept?
Thank you very much.
Yes. Have a good day, everyone.
You too.
Yes. I'm sorry. Say it one more time.
You mentioned karma.
Yes.
Which is, I connect with more Eastern philosophy.
Yes.
And how do you explain it in your belief system? Or is it the same?
It's almost the same.
Yeah.
It's almost the same. That actually, you know, we got those actually from the Europeans that came here.
Oh, okay.
See, in those times of the Lakota, we did it with ceremonies. We did it with our languages. Because English was never around because English is such a deceitful language. So everywhere to where, you know, ceremonies and our language is sacred, that we learned, we got that from the Europeans when Columbus came. He gave us everything. So English is so many different languages. It has so many meanings. So many definitions, so many abbreviations. That's a lot for a human being to know. You got so many different languages, Spanish, Lakota, and Navajo, different Arapaho, and Cherokee language, so many languages that you know in your spirit from your heart, but work with your mind to what's your strong point. Heart or mind, or what part of your body, of your son, your name, and so forth. It's always an honor to know to where, you know, people say what comes around goes around. Well, no. They only know that because of knowing their mentalities. Most likely to where a person has feelings. Every single man, male to male balance has feelings, has the same hurt, the same pain, the same spirit, the same emotions. So you put those all, everyone can speak many different languages. So karma is only to wear it over your head because people think too much. People that are in businesses and are into major cities that live in big cities and, you know, how they go out and do things and they think ahead of what without them stimulating the minds with the poison stuff, the alcohol, drugs. It's not good for your body. Those right there, they numbs you. So most likely, I never drink, I never did drugs, I never experimented. So without having anger, frustration, confusions, and off balance, you're having all these things in your head, that creates karma. Okay? That's why your will is how fast they spin. That's up to you how fast you want to spin. Use your heart spirit that's connected to your head spirit. Mm-hmm. You use your heart. This is why the elements is telling you, all of your animals and insects, to make a step with love. Do things with love. Look at things with love. Having things with love. What's around you is love. That's what the elements of a woman's covenant is telling you. That's what's creating the healing process. So many elements, how much a woman can handle in this life. A woman can handle more than anything that a man does. Without a woman, how she's a backbone of this land. How she creates an energy, spiritual guidance. How mentally, how her state of mind is, how her heart, or the beauty of a woman, and how they do what a man does to find directions, they find guidances. Just like a man finds guidances, defines a woman for guidance and directions. Just like a woman finds answers and guidances. She follows her heart. That's where she asks questions. Everyone has accomplished new things. That's what we're here for. There's more that we haven't seen. That's why life is about. What is your main thing? What's your main source to what you want to follow? To have a love that you have made success in life and beautiful things in life that will make you smile to your mate, to your children, to your grandchildren, and so forth. That is all from the heart. It's powerful than anything. What everything is why we're still alive today. And think why we're still alive. Why we wake up in the morning and look in the mirror. It is like looking at yourself like, wow. You're changing? Yes. Your feelings? Yes. What is to prepare? You have to work on it. You have to find it. And you'd be amazed at how the heart provides you. There's a lot of things I haven't seen yet. I'm thinking for the next 5-10 years. But there's going to be more directions on my path. That's why you have bear people. Tells you to create a path. It's a sacred path. Name your sacred path, your sacred responsibility, your sacred love, and your sacred way. Name those. Find them. If you haven't found them yet, you're still finding them. If you're a 50, 60-year-old, if you're a 70-year-old, if you're an 80-year-old, you're still looking. Yeah.
Thank you.
Well, yes?
Is it possible to talk a little bit about the most ridiculous is when you
I was asked to that today.
If you can speak of that, if that's about
it is a very sacred element. Today, a person asked me about my headdress. The headdresses symbolize more of a purple heart. Everything around me, there are 60 month-olds. 60 month-olds all around. all in eagle feathers.